I'm not above the law. I do have an absolute right to pardon myself. But I'll never have to do it because I didn't do anything wrong. And everybody knows it.
That was President Trump Friday saying that he has the absolute right to pardon himself. The latest constitutional question to come from the Mueller probe. In a letter to the special counsel in January, the president's legal team went even further with its claims of executive power, saying, quote, it remains our position that the president's actions here, by virtue of his position as the chief law enforcement officer, could neither constitutionally nor legally constitute obstruction, because that would amount to him obstructing himself, and that he could, if he wished, terminate the inquiry or even exercise his power to pardon if he so desired. David Rifkin is a constitutional attorney who served in the White House Counsel's Office and Justice Department in the Reagan and George H.W. Bush administrations. I should add that David is also a frequent contributor to the Wall Street Journal. Welcome.
So good to be with you.
Does the president have the power to pardon himself just as a constitutional matter?
Absolutely, leaving aside the political wisdom of this. This is actually an easy question. The text of a constitution puts only two limitations. It has to be offense against the United States, and it cannot be used in cases of impeachment. Then Charles Pinckney introduced the proposal with the language involved. He indicated at the time there was analogous to the royal prerogative, which included at that time power to pardon any offenses against, except for impeachment. And there was a debate at the time which involved whether or not treason, Paul, should be removed from the list of offenses, and its most serious offense for which you can be pardoned. That debate was resolved in favor of the original text. This is one of those few constitutional issues. There's no serious doubt. The president can pardon absolutely anybody, including himself.
All right, so what about the response then, that this means, in essence, the president is above the law because he could presumably pardon himself even if he were accused of corruption?
I understand, but this is a classical rhetorical argument. To say the president is above the law begs the question of what the law is. The pardon power is plenary, which is to say absolute, and the check on the exercise of his power, as many other instances in the constitutional architecture, is another political response to an abuse of power, and that, Paul, is impeachment. But to be honest, I sort of chuckle when I hear analogous to the king, which, by the way, in this case is appropriate. The pardon power is analogous to the prerogative. And by the way, the notion that nobody can be a judge in his own case ignores the proposition that Supreme Court has articulated in several cases dealing with pardon. It is not a judicial power. Okay?
Right.
He's not judging anybody. He's deciding that a given pardon is in the public interest.
Well,
and if he's wrong, he'll be punished for it impeachment-wise.
Well, that's so what you're saying is that under the Constitution, the check on his authority is political. It is that the Congress of the United States, well, the public can obviously vote him out after one term, but also the Congress of the United States has the power to impeach him, and of course they define, the Congress defines, what are high crimes and misdemeanors.
Absolutely, and again, let me emphasize, this very issue was debated in the context of excluding treason involving a number of framers, and the answer was put forward by Pinckney, is that if a president, because the scenario was the president engages in treasonous act, pardons his associates,
right,
so they cannot testify against him, and the answer was he'll get impeached.
Right. Okay, now you raised it, you implied that you think it would be a bad idea politically to pardon himself. Explain that.
At this point in time, it would be a bad idea. There was an argument to be made, which I actually made, as you know, Paul, a number of months ago when the investigation was still going. I suggested that in lieu of firing Mueller, which I thought was a bad idea and still is, you can in fact deprive him of his jurisdiction by pardoning everybody. But that was before all the indictments that came out. At this point in time, it just would not be judicious.
Because it would look like he was attempting to cover up, even if he has nothing to cover up?
That would be the perception.
Okay, so, and when you suggested pardoning, you were saying everybody, that included Hillary Clinton, anybody involved.
Correct.
In the Clinton emails case, so just basically sweep everything clean of this issuance and put it all behind us.
No, not entirely behind, but one caveat. We were suggesting at the time letting Congress, a forlorn hope, have Congress really seriously investigate with nobody being able to take the fifth. The whole idea was to treat it as a public policy political exercise and not a investigatory judicial exercise.
Right, get to the bottom of it for the American people and tell us what happened. What about the claims in the president's lawyer's memos that came out last week about the obstruction issue and whether or not in firing James Comey as FBI director, that could be determined to be an act of obstruction of justice? I gather you agree with the president's lawyers. Why?
I agree with President's lawyers. Made the same case for you in back last December. It's simple. It's not that the president can never obstruct justice. There are circumstances which he can, like bribing a witness. But while the president is exercising core constitutional powers of his office, like firing people or hiring people or pardoning people or telling people what to do, he cannot possibly be engaged in obstruction, because to allow Congress to pass statutes that hold him accountable criminally here, in fact, would impede his ability to function as a robust chief executive. It's a very simple argument.
But what if for example, the president would fire an assistant U.S. attorney or a FBI director because he knows that those people are investigating friends of his who are corrupt and might testify against him? In that case, can he still have the right to fire them and not be obstructing?
He is right. Again, the important thing, just like with pardons, if he is doing things in a way that amounts, in fact, to politically serious and damaging exercise, he can be impeached. But let me tell you, the problem of holding the opposite argument is you could literally hobble the president in the exercise of his core functions. And then remember this, the president is in a unique position. The president has personal interests. The president's interest as the chief executive. How is Article III court supposed to discern whether or not he pardoned Sheriff Arpaio for a good reason or bad reason, or he fired Comey for a good reason or bad reason?
All right, thank you, David. Fascinating constitutional debate. Good to see you.